Hello, and welcome along to Animation Basics in Adobe After Effects with your host, Robert Smith. In this video, we're going to create a slideshow with an animated logo introduction. Okay, now here we are in Photoshop. I've got my file ready, and this is the file we're going to use. They're all still files. As you can see, it's many layers like this. I might turn these layers on so you can actually see the slides, and I'll leave them turned on too. Okay, so that's the Photoshop file. It's a simple layered Photoshop file with a background like that, and then some slides, and then we have also the logo separated into four different layers. As you can see, I turned them off like that. Okay, so everything's on its own layer. It's all been named correctly. It's ready to go. Let's go to After Effects and let's use this file. So Command Tab over to After Effects like this. I'm going to file import that file. There it is, striped and logo PSD. Now it's very important, as discussed in many other videos, to import this as a composition and retain the layer sizes. Okay, let's open that. Let's have a look at it. And again, After Effects asks us, do we sure we want to do that? Yes, we're very sure. So okay that. Okay, so After Effects has created a folder to keep all our assets neat, and also a composition. So let's double click on this composition like this. As you can see, it now opens up. We have our video viewing area over here. We have our timeline down the bottom and our project window. Now this, the last video I made was obviously 60 seconds long, because that's what this is. So I need to change that. So I'm going to go to composition settings, and 1280, 720 is good. Square pixels, 25 is good. I need to change this to 30 seconds, which is 100 times 30, which is 3000. Type in 3000 and OK. And now my timeline is only 30 seconds long. OK, let's do some management on this timeline. What we need to do is, if we turn on all the layers to see them all, you'll see we've got our logo over here and we've got our slides. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to lock the background layer and the top layer, which is just a cover. You'll see how that works in a minute. So those two are locked. Then I'm going to lock these four bottom layers like that. These are the slide layers. And I'm going to select them. Actually, before I do that, I'll just unlock them and just select them like this with the shift key down and just drag them to the right, because we're not going to use those for a while. So I'll just get them out of the way and drag them over here like that. And then I'll lock those layers. Okay, the layers we're going to start off with are these four layers here. And that's this animated logo. So to do that, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to 1 second in time by clicking over here, typing in 100, and press return, and now my cursor will go to 1 second in time. I might zoom in a bit using this yellow thing here, like, by clicking and dragging that till I get to single seconds. Oh, there we are. We've got single seconds, which is what we want. Okay. Now the property I'm going to animate to start with is the position property. So I'm just going to click that first layer, hold the shift key down, select the red square layer. So now I've got four layers selected. I'm going to press the letter P like this to isolate just that position property. Now at 1 second in time, we want our animated logo to be sitting exactly where it is. So to do that, I'm going to click on position like this. Then I'm going to go back to the start like that. I'm going to deselect by clicking anywhere over here and work on each layer individually. First of all, the red square. I'll click on that layer like that. And with the shift key down, I'm going to click and use the arrows just to drag it right off the stage or off the video viewing area like that. And you'll notice we get an automatic keyframe straight away. Okay, now the red circle. I'll do the same thing with this time. I'll go to the top. And again, it won't have as far to travel, so it'll probably travel a little bit slower. Okay, and the star shape, I'm going to drag that right to the left. You notice how I get these automatic keyframes like that as it zooms off to the left like that. Now that's what this top layer is all about, this cover layer here. That's covering, that's just another layer, which is just the background repeated like that. And the down arrow, I'll do the same thing with that. Select that, hold the shift key down and move that off to the right like this. And now I've got some animations. So let's have a look at that. As you can see, they all animate into place beautifully. Okay, what I need to do now is add a bit of rotation. So I'll make sure I've selected that layer and the red square layer, those four layers like that. I'm going to press the letter R, and now I've got the rotation keyframes. I'm going to put a keyframe in the first frame like that. Remember, rotation works backwards. You actually put the zero rotation in the first frame. And then I'm going to go to 1 second again. Type in 100 over here. And I'm going to select one of these first numbers and type in 1. And now they'll all rotate 1. So let's have a look at that. Go back to the start. That's exactly what I want. Fantastic. Now I want to see both rotation and my position keyframes. To do that, I'm going to press the letter U. Letter U will show you all the keyframes on selected layers. It's quite a handy shortcut, and U will close it up again. So letter U for universe. I'm just going to select all of those keyframes by dragging a marquee over the top and go to animation, keyframe assistant, easy ease, like that. So they're going to zoom in nicely, just like that. Then I'm going to go to 4 seconds in time. To do that, I'm going to go over here and type in 400, like that, which takes my current time indicator to 4 seconds. Now I'm going to put a position and a rotation manual keyframe in there, so nothing happens, so they don't rotate between that keyframe and this keyframe. Nothing's going to happen. That's what those two keyframes are going to do. Okay, just a quick shortcut to get between keyframes quickly. Press letter K to go to the right and letter J to go to the left. It's K to the right, J to the left. It'll take your current time indicator to that place in time. So I'm going to go to K like that. Now I'm at 4 seconds. I also now want to add a transparency. Property. So to do that, while I've got these selected, I'm going to hold the shift key down and press the letter T, and it will add the opacity to our selection of keyframes. So then I'm going to click on opacity like that to put in my initial keyframe at 100%, like that. Then I'm going to move along my timeline by selecting that number there, typing in 500. That'll take me to 5 seconds in time. Now, all I want to do now, basically, in the position, I simply want to select each layer individually. So I'm going to click on the first one, the down arrow, and I'm just going to move it just a little bit to the right, just a little bit like that. Now the star shape, I'm going to move just a little bit, dragging that just a little bit to the left, like that. The red circle, I'm just going to drag using the Y this time, which is the second number. Drag that down a little bit, and I'll go to the red square and do the same thing. I'll move it up, that's the X. With the Y one, I'll move it up just a little bit like that. And I'll zoom back down so I can see all those layers. I'll select that layer and select that layer. Now they're all selected. And I'm going to grab the opacity and just drag it down to zero, like that. So now we have, let's have a look at that animation. The first 5 seconds, on comes the logo, then it slowly falls apart and fades out. Let's just add one little bit more to this. I'm going to close up all those layers. I've finished with those. I can lock those layers now too. They're finished. I'm going to go up here to my type tool, my type selection tool, like this. And I'm going to click anywhere on the stage like this and type in the word Digit Guy, which is going to be the name of the company, like that. That's a little bit too big, so I'll hold the command and the shift key down on the left angle bracket, like this. Just make it a bit smaller. And I need to actually see that, where that's going to be, so I need to know it's going to go right underneath that. I need to go back up here and go back to my pointer tool, grab this and just drag that to about here. It's a little bit too big, so over here on the type I can just drop the size down a little bit by dragging that to the left, which is what I want. Fantastic. Okay, so that's there. So what I really want, I want that to come in as the animation happens. So I'm going to drag my current time head to about here. So just after about 1 second is where I want this layer to start. So I'm just going to simply click and drag it to about there, like that. I'm going to make sure that type layer is selected and press the letter T, like this, for opacity, if you like. And I'm going to drag the opacity back to zero, like that. And I'm going to move on just a fraction, about half a second down the timeline, and bring it up to 100% by dragging that to the right. So that's going to fade in. So let's have a look at that. Just press the space bar. In comes the logo. And let's have a look at that in real time. Actually, that's fading in a bit too quickly, so I'm just going to click and drag that keyframe to the right just a little bit, so give it maybe a second to fade in. So in it comes, and it fades in beautifully. It's exactly what I want. Okay, I'm going to zoom back out a little bit just so I can see that a bit more of my timeline. Now I'm going to go to 4 seconds in time by selecting that and typing in 400, like that. Press return. And now what I want is just to fade that back out again. To do that, I'm simply going to click on the opacity and make sure I put a manual keyframe so it stays at 100% like that. And then just move it along to about 5 seconds, exactly 5 seconds in fact, and drop that back to zero. Okay, so there's the first part of our animation, our logo. This will be your own logo that you've broken up into layers with a background like this. If you press the space bar, on it comes. I'll just click anywhere like that to get rid of that selection, so we can see it a bit better. And just on it comes, on fades the name, and then they both fade away beautifully together. Okay, that's my first animated logo. We'll do the slides in the next video. Thanks for watching.